Hey everyone, welcome to Michi Blue Tarot, welcome to my channel. This is Neelam back for you with another reading today. Okay, so this is an energy update that I do. Usually I try to do it on a weekly basis, but I know that I haven't done it in a bit. Okay, so here we are. This is your love life in the next 7 days. So how I do it is, I think, something that you guys already know. So first what I check is, I check your, I try to see what's going on currently, and then I see the probable next 7 days, okay? But today what I've done is I've just picked up two oracle cards from two of my favorite decks. One is the Sacred Destiny Oracle and the other one is The Answer is Simple. So that will help us navigate better into the messages for you today. So, today seems to be like a very, today I've been this very contemplative, I've been thinking a lot. So maybe let's see what we get today for you guys. So before we begin, private readings are open, so you can reach out to me. Also guys, one advice before you guys watch my videos. Just make sure that when you are choosing your piles, I'm saying this again, whenever you're choosing your piles, just make sure that you're in a very calm mind, okay? Just don't go, like, I understand you might be waiting for my videos and, you know, the moment it is posted, you just want to watch it right away. I get that. And even I do it for a lot of readers. But advice that I would want to give you is, you see the post, fine. Now, when you're free, when there is nothing that you need to think, or maybe you have a 2-hour gap or something like that, when you are absolutely free, no stress, is when I would want you to watch this video, so that you guys can choose the correct pile. So when you are not in a good frame of mind, you'll not be able to choose the right pile for yourself. Okay, it's very natural. Alright, so let us begin. This is your love life in the next 7 days. So as you can see, I have three piles today. Number one is the selenite wand. Number two is the fluorite crystal. This is a beautiful green color and I just recently got it and I'm just like in love with it. It is so gorgeous and mesmerizing. Okay, and the third one is labradorite. Look at this, labradorite. So this is a crystal which has a bluish bling. And I think I'm very attracted to this particular crystal, labradorite, in any form. I don't know why. Maybe it's just meant to be my thing. I've seen a lot of people being attracted to amethyst more than anything else, but this is my attraction. Okay, so take a deep breath, guys. Go ahead, choose your piles, and I will begin with number one, which is the selenite. Go ahead, guys. All right, so I'll begin with number one. Let's put these aside. Okay, so here we are. This is the selenite wand. Your love life in the next 7 days, pile number one. Okay. So I have reach out and blessings. Sorry. I think these two cards are, sorry about my throat guys, these two cards here are telling me that you guys need to be a little more connected to your source, okay? I think the blessings are right around you. All you need to do is just call out for it, or maybe just say it, okay? I'm so sorry. I know, I just choked right away. I opened this pile. I'm seeing here more of a very ancestral blessing kind of a connection between, I mean, between you and your divine powers. So when I say divine powers, it's more of manifestation, like what you want exactly, okay? So here I'm getting a very clear vibe that it's all around you if you decide to reach out, okay? We'll look into the detailing with the tarot cards. So first, let me see the current situation and then I will knit it up for you. What's happening currently in this connection for pile number one? What is happening in this connection? Four of Pentacles and Two of Swords. Okay. So currently I feel that one of you is holding back from this connection and the other one is confused because of that. Okay. And the could also be that the person who's holding back, okay, is holding back because of some sort of a decision that they need to take. Yeah, there is silence. I think that you guys are not talking too much to each other right now. I think both of you are keeping all the emotions and the pent up stuff inside you at this stage, because maybe you guys are not really sure how to proceed, what to do. That's probably the reason why I'm getting the message of reaching out. So maybe you guys need to spend a little more time praying, meditating, thinking what exactly do you want out of this connection, okay? I'm at this stage seeing both of you confused. Even if you are clear, I'm seeing your person absolutely confused, and even you are not like crystal clear. There are some doubts here and there, okay? There are some doubts here and there that I see. But the advice is to reach out, okay? I am seeing silence. I'm seeing confusion at this stage. So if this part of it is resonating, then I think we'll see the probable next 7 days what could happen. If this resonates, then probably the outcome will also resonate with you. Okay, I'm seeing absolute no clarity at all. Like how, where is this going? I'm also seeing that, you know, maybe you are holding on to this connection very tightly because you don't want to lose out on it. And no matter how confusing it has become, because maybe you're very attached to this person and you don't want to let go. Yeah, could be that your person is running away from this connection, okay? They don't want to express themselves, they don't want to say anything right now. They could be keeping an eye on you, but at the same time I feel that they are being a little manipulative, okay? Even more than manipulative, I feel that they're not telling you how exactly they're feeling at this point, okay? Because of their own XYZ reasons. So I see an absolute confusion here. It's a very heavily confusing energy and indecisive energy. Okay, so let's see now what could the probable 7 days bring for you. Some blessing definitely, otherwise we would not have had this blessing card. I think maybe for a lot of you, you need to be clear about what you want from this connection. Maybe that's what you need to reach out. Maybe you just need to write down stuff that, okay, this is how I see this connection to be in my life and this is what I want out of it. Okay, so maybe you need to think like that. Let me see. Next 7 days for pile number one. The moon, okay. I see a lot of thinking here, a lot of fears. Six of Swords, Queen of Swords, Knight of Pentacles. Okay. All right, so next 7 days, I do feel that your words are going to be a blessing for you. Okay, if you get what I'm saying. The next 7 days, you, as I said, you will have to journal, you will have to write, or you will have to talk to yourself that this is what I want from this connection. Okay? I see that both of you, it's not only you or them. I think both of you are fearful. I think both of you have issues. You guys are not very sure where this is heading, what is going to happen, blah, blah, blah. So I'm seeing that you're constantly going to be thinking about this person. You have some fears in your mind. Sometimes you might just decide to leave. Sometimes you might just decide to come. So in the next 7 days, I see if you do this, I mean, there's a reason why I picked up these two oracles, so that, you know, maybe if the outcome is not good, you know how to change it, okay? If you decide to speak your mind out to the divine, not to your person, if you decide to speak your mind out to your faith, basically if you believe in any God, or if you do law of attraction, or if you do journaling, if you do that, all right, if you talk and if you know what you want, I see this person also becoming a little stable. See, 10 of cups. I see this person also becoming a little stable. Maybe you have to be the guiding light in this connection. I'm seeing a lot of divine feminine energy these days, guys. I mean, even for my Instagram. Okay, if you guys want, you can go and check out my Instagram. I do daily messages over there. So you can, it's Mishy Blue Tarot. So you can go and see that as well. Because I, over there also, the last reading that I did was a lot about a divine feminine energy. So maybe this part of the time right now is about divine feminine leading the way. At this stage, I feel you will have to be very clear, 8 of Wands. You will have to be very clear about, very specific about what you want, okay? And things might change. Otherwise, this confusion will keep going on. Your person is not going to get clarity on their own. You are the one who might just bring in the clarity for them, okay? 1 second. Yeah, so I'm seeing this that, you know, they will not get it on their own. I mean, if this is not a feminine watching, then it is the feminine energy who's going to bring the clarity. If you're the guy watching, then the message for you is to wait for your feminine to make a move. Because I see a very strong feminine energy. I have Queen of Swords, I have Moon, I have the High Priestess. So I'm seeing the feminine very, very strong here. Okay, so wait for that. Let me just pull out a card for advice. But then yes, I mean, advice wise, the oracles have said it very clearly. It's blessing and reach out. Okay, so the advice here is also judgment. You will have to tell them what you feel. Okay, or you will have to be very vocal about what you want in this connection, or what you think, or where this connection is going. You have to be very vocal. You have to speak the truth. You will have to yourself first understand what you want from this connection. Okay? And if you are single and if you're watching this reading, then I think this is telling you that if any relationship is not working out for you, then the reason is probably you're not decided about what kind of relationship you want in your life. Okay? You have to decide that. Alright? And the moment you decide this, I feel somebody will come in your life. The point is right now, because you're confused, this is sending out a very confused vibe also to the universe. So understand this thing. Okay? That's what I'm picking up for pile number one, guys. So it's right there. All you need to do is be very specific and clear about what you want. And I see that happening. So I think I've given you what I could pick up from the tarot cards today. Do let me know in the comments if this made sense to you. Also, private readings are open, so you can reach out to me for that as well. And I hope this gives you clarity for your next 7 days. I see this working out only if the divine feminine has to take the lead. And if you're the masculine, then you'd probably have to wait. Because I don't think you can get the clarity on your own here. Okay, guys? So, thank you so much for watching. I will see you soon again with another reading. Take care and bye-bye. Okay. So now let's move to the fluorite pile, pile number 2. Okay. So your love life in the next 7 days, pile number 2, fluorite. So let's see what we get. Success. Woohoo! This is nice. This is nice stuff. I like it. Dare to be happy. Are you not being happy, pile number 2? Maybe you're scared. You will get the success, but don't be scared. Okay? Be free. The advice, look at this girl. You need to be free in order to feel happy. You have to embrace this happily. Okay? So how I'm going to do this right now is, first I'm going to pick up the cards to see the current situation, and then we look at the outcome. So if the current situation resonates, then probably the outcome will also for you. Okay, so let me see what's going on currently for pile number 2 in their love life. Pile number 2, current situation. Oops, Queen of Cups and Tower. A little more. Oh my God. Okay, pile number 2. I think you had a very, very bad past. Okay, this is you only. This is your energy. Or for some of you, it could be your person's energy. I think your past is still ruling you, and probably that's the reason why you are resisting this connection. But I don't know why I strongly feel this is you. You are not confident about it. You feel as if you will be hurt again, and you're just resisting it. Okay?
Yeah.
Ace of Cups. This is a new thing in your life, guys. This is a new love offer. This is beautiful. Okay? And you are just choosing to be silent about it. You're scared to invest. This could be your person's energy also, I'm saying again. But for a lot of you, I mean, I think this 70% of you, this is your energy. Take it how it resonates. But I'm seeing that you are afraid. What's coming now is a very, very beautiful connection. Or if you already know this person, then you know who I'm talking about. Or if you don't, then probably this person is about to come. You need to just get out of this energy. You probably were very giving with this particular past that you had with a person. You were the Queen of Cups there. You were so emotional that probably you did not control your emotions at all. Okay, and I think it just blew up. It blew up really bad. Okay, and this is more of a past energy I'm picking up. Okay, now that this thing is ended, there's something new that is coming and you're resisting it. You are not daring to be happy because you feel that, you know, again you will make yourself vulnerable to feel hurt. And I do get it. Trust me, guys, I do get it. It happens. But sometimes it's that risk that you need to take. And then I have the success card here. So it's not telling me as if, you know, this is going to be bad for you though. Okay? This could be your person's energy. This could be your energy. Okay? But the thing is, we're looking at your love life. So I think this is more of your energy. I think you are the one who's staying silent and staying quiet about the whole, you know, this cup runneth over of love. All right, there is a lot in this connection. I can see that there is a lot of emotions. There is a lot of chemistry. This is like a gift that has come to you from the universe, and it's just led to a lot of things shedding off. For a lot of you, maybe you've just let go of a lot of past patterns, and I can see that. Okay, but it's not like a very simple thing. Okay, I am seeing that, you know, it's tough for you to open up again. It's tough for you to be like what you were. But now let's see, how does the next 7 days look between the two of you, or just in general for you? Next 7 days for pile number two. Oops. Okay, I'm going to take this, which is the Nine of Pentacles. Okay. I see you being single. I still feel, okay, for pile number two, I think you will be happy. It's not like you're not happy. But, you know, you reach a point in your life where you just feel that, okay, with so much of effort, I've been able to establish this. I mean, maybe you were a very emotional person and suddenly you became very practical. And now you've reached a very comfortable zone of practicality where, you know, you are happy with yourself. So again, something like this has come. So it's just shook your world. Okay. It's just kind of pushing you to be a little more, probably just asking you to be like before, but you're just hell bent on holding on to this energy. Okay. You feel that, you know, it's been a tough journey, and you know that, you know, this is what it is. This is what practicality is. You've changed yourself over time and you don't want to go back to what you were. And then it's going to become a little unbearable for you to handle it. Okay. Let's see what else. What else in the next 7 days for pile number two? Ooh. Guys, Two of Cups. Okay, I think this person is head over heels for you. Let me be very honest. This person is realizing what they feel for you. Okay, but the way they are coming to you could be small. Okay. Alright, I mean, I am feeling very intense energies here. I'm feeling thirsty also. So I am seeing that this person is not going to give up on you. Okay, this person is not going to give up on you. This person has felt certain emotions after a really long time, and probably this person might not tell you what they're feeling. They might not tell you what they're feeling, okay? But they will not let you go, okay? I'm seeing that, you know, this person looks at you as their empress, okay? And they are the King of Wands is what I'm seeing. You can take it however the genders are, it's okay. It doesn't matter. If you're a man watching, then probably, you know, your woman looks at you as someone who's good enough to be the father of your kids. So, I mean, father of her kids. So, I'm actually hearing the word that, you know, give this a shot. Give this a chance. Let's see where this goes. This person might come to you with a small offer, okay? This person might come to you with a small offer. I'm seeing a Page of Pentacles, okay? So it's not like they're not giving you anything. They are, okay? And it seems to be like a mesmerizing connection for you as well as your person. So see, this person is not ready to give up. This person is not ready to give up. This person just wants to come to you. They have manifested you and they've thought a lot about you, okay? And they just don't want to let this go, guys, because I'm seeing that your person does feel that, you know, you are their love, okay? You have ignited certain emotions in them which they hadn't felt, and probably even they are confused because of that. So they want to take it slowly, okay? That's why I told you that maybe they're not showing it all to you right away. Okay, you guys could be soulmates from the past life. I have to mention this because two cards are the same sort. They are probably not showing you what they feel. They are being very practical about what they give you. But this is going to be a slow process. This is going to be a slow process. Okay, I don't think that they are like right away rushing into a commitment. But then I am also getting that they will not want you to leave them. Okay, they will make sure that you're around. However, and that is because they find you very independent and charming. Okay, they find you very independent, beautiful, very opinionated, and they don't want you to let go of those energies, of that independence and all of that. They don't want you to leave that behind for them. They just love you for who you are, and they want to give you something. They want to have something with you. Okay. So the advice here, let me pick one tarot card, but already we've seen dare to be happy and you will get success. Just dare it. King of Swords. Knight of Wands. So here I'm seeing that even if you cut off this person has so much of passion for you, they will not give up. They will just not give up. For a lot of you, this could be a very strong soulmate from the past life. So, advice here is to not feel scared of the connection. Okay, just give it a shot once and see how it goes. But yeah, again, you are not like before. You have changed. It's not like you will land up hurting yourself right away. I have to say this because I know how it feels. Okay, you will not hurt yourself. You know where to draw the line. You can be there and at the same time just be a little focused on, okay, it's just the beginning. Let me not invest so much into it. I understand. Okay? So, but then don't just end it. Don't just let it go. Alright? Okay, pile number two. Let me know in the comments who's chosen this pile because it seems to be like pretty intense. Also, you guys can go and follow my Instagram page. I do daily readings over there. Also, private readings are open, so you can reach out to me for the same if you feel like it ever. And I will see you soon again with another reading. Till then, please take care of yourself and bye-bye. Okay, pile number three is the Labradorite crystal. Yeah, I love this crystal, guys, you know. This is like so beautiful. It has this blue bling, if you notice. It's gorgeous. I want a wand, a Labradorite wand sometime. Let's see if I find it. Okay, so let's see your love life in the next 7 days. Truth. Okay. Step away from the crowd. Okay. Interesting. Some sort of an awakening. This is giving me the judgment card vibe, the truth card. Some sort of an awakening for sure. So how I'm going to do this is, I'm going to be picking up cards on the current situation first. If that resonates, then probably the outcome will also resonate with you. So let's see. Current situation. I will elaborate on this card after I pick up some tarot cards. Two of Wands. I think a lot of you have been waiting for something. Could be your person, and this wait has just become like never ending, and your person seems to be in love with you, but very controlled, very controlled. This card is giving me more of a vibe of like, you know, you getting fed up. Yeah, Seven of Swords. Do you see there is a link here? Okay, for a lot of you, I feel that, you know, with all of this going on, you not being able to see things clearly in your connection, you don't know where this is going. You feel that you do feel that, you know, this is not what you want, probably. You're getting into that mindset. The Devil. You're angry, could be, for a lot of you. I see a lot of anger. You've been waiting and probably your person just doesn't seem to be opening up. And I feel that, you know, there has been a moment of truth which has just told you that what the hell am I doing? Like, you know, that kind of an epiphanical call. You know that, okay, am I even making sense that, you know, I've been waiting but there is no response. Nothing is happening. There is no decision. And I feel left out in the cold all the time. Is this even for me at this stage? This is what probably you're thinking. And your person, I'm not saying that they don't love you, but they are stuck. And their stuckness could be karmic, guys. Okay? Could be that, you know, they just cannot open up no matter what. Okay? They just cannot do it. I see them feeling very, very stuck in this situation with overall, the whole thing basically, they can't open up, you keeping, and I feel sad for your person because they don't want to let you go, but at the same time, they cannot express what they are feeling, okay? I don't know if they don't love you, they're not playing around with you or anything, but their problem is genuine and even your anger is genuine. Like, I mean, I can't take sides here. So I do understand where your person is coming from, because sometimes you just cannot say anything because you just can't say anything. Okay, you just don't know what to do. Like, I mean, even if you love someone so much, you just can't express it because maybe you've had some past experiences, or maybe you're just like holding back, like you're not wanting to give in. And I do understand this emotion. Okay, and you, on the other hand, you feel really caught up in this situation because you've given your best and now you don't feel as if, you know, it's worth it. Okay, now let me see if this part of it resonated with you. Then let's see what do the next 7 days bring for you. Next 7 days for pile number 3. For pile number 3. Okay, dude, this is bizarre. I just saw this card while shuffling and I didn't take it. And it's here. I see you becoming free. Yeah, I see you becoming free. I see you understanding the truth. And I see that, you know, you are no longer going to just be emotional about everything. No. I see this person might just show you their soft side, that, you know, I also have issues, please understand me and all of that. They might tell this to you, but I don't see you listening to it. I don't think that you will listen to it because you've had enough. You've had enough. You've given them all the love. You've given them everything. Okay, but it just feels as if, you know, your person is not going to get the power to manifest. Like, this thing is giving me the vibe that, you know, that I'm talking in your lingo, all right? I love you, you love me, I understand the whole thing, but how long are we going to continue like this where you don't say anything? You don't want to, I mean, come forward. You don't want to express what you're feeling. When is the movement going to come? When is the movement going to come? With the Eight of Swords here, you know, all of this energy seems to be like all caught up because, you know the truth. You know the truth. The truth is that you both love each other. But where is this going? Where is this going? Ten of Wands. Is it just going to be a troublesome situation for the rest of your life? Or is something better going to come ever? Okay, I see you kind of doing this sort of a self-questioning with yourself. And then I think that you're going to take it very lightly now. You're not going to invest too much of yourself into it because you have borne the brunt of investing a lot in this connection. And you don't know. You just don't know where could this go. What could happen here. Okay, you don't know. You're feeling very skeptical. You're feeling a little bit anxious also. To an extent, and there is, you know, this talking has to happen. There is like your person is silent, you are angry because they are silent, and there is no talking ultimately happening. So I'm seeing you become very lighter. You will not expect too much is what I feel, and I'm not seeing you ending this connection, no. But yeah, it's like a moment of truth for you where you understand that, okay, I'm probably aligning my expectations in the wrong place. So I might as well withdraw myself and just expect things from a better space than keep going on over here. Okay, I see you come in a little bit of a mature energy. I see you in a little bit of a more thought through energy here. Okay, you are stepping away. Now I get what it was. You are stepping away from the crowd, the fool over here. Okay, because you don't see where is this heading, you will kind of probably take a break and you might just spend that time thinking and you might want to, just take things light so that it does not impact your mind and body, because I do see a lot of anxiety and conflict here. Not from your side, but more from your person's side, I feel. Okay? Okay, so that's what I have for pile number 3, guys. Also, you can go and check out my Instagram. It's Mishy Blue Tarot. So I do daily card pickups over there, like daily messages. So in case if you are a tarot fan, you can follow that as well. Private readings are open, so you can reach out to me for the same. Till then, take care of yourself. Take care of your health. Bye-bye.